Let's take a look at the C++ 23 features. What? What's an iota? What?
Where is my static reflection?
You might remember Luca from this video about the Chip8 emulator. Well, he wants to start working on his own game soon, and I would love to also take part in that. The only problem is that he wants to make the game in either C or ZIG. If you are not new to this channel, you probably know that I can do C, but I don't know any ZIG, so let's give that a try. The main problem with ZIG is that it is a new language, so basically version 1.0 is not even released yet, so there might be limited help online, but after searching a little, I found a quick start tutorial to my liking, and struggled for a bit to make ZIG work with Visual Studio Code. I managed eventually to get an older version working and printed my first Hello World ZIG program. While going through my ZIG story, I'll also tell you the things that I liked about it, and the first one is the build system. In C++, for example, you have to use an external build language like CMake, and it is just horrible to set up. This is why my CMake tutorials are something like, yeah, use my template and never touch it again. And there are like 100 options like CMake, Make,
Amogus,
Premake, that compiles to CMake, that builds the C++ project, so yeah, it is a mess. In ZIG, however, use ZIG to build your project. Isn't that nice? You don't have to learn another less powerful language to build your code. And so, you can, for example, make your own building tool like this one, that I made in C++ for showcase, but the idea is that you can make something like this in ZIG, okay? Okay, so after setting things up, I found this nice repo called ZigLinks that has 100 small ZIG exercises to teach you the basics of this language. And they even have a small surprise at the end, so I can't wait to see what that actually is, but we'll see that together later. The problem is that it seems like they want me to use the latest version of ZIG, so yeah, this won't take much, I hope. After that, I started to learn the basics of ZIG, and I'm not quite a fan of the syntax so far, but that shouldn't be the main reason to judge the programming language on. There are many features of ZIG that would benefit game developers, like, for example, allocator-aware design and static reflection, so it deserves a try. If you remember my video on how to learn C++, you probably remember about this nice website called CodeWars, where you can practice programming languages. But after checking it out, it seems like ZIG is not a supported language here, so yeah. I could continue with ZigLinks, but solving a full programming test from scratch would help me memorize the syntax better. So I hopped on Discord to ask my community what to implement, and after telling me to give me a project idea, and explaining them that I'm a complete beginner, this is what I got. Flappy Bird? Bro, I don't even know how to read the input. So, I did something completely unheard of before in this YouTube channel. I used my brain to come up with a project idea, and so I chose to make something that would solve mazes, and here it is. And it is beautiful, and I don't care what you have to say about it. Then, I went on to work more on the ZigLinks, and I have to say that I'm impressed. The first thing that I liked was the fact that the type system was consistent and had useful features like how optionals are built into the language, and there are some int-language shortcuts to check if they store any value. They also have pointers with a similar syntax to C, but to access the value, you do that like accessing a member. The nice thing is that pointers can be null, so you don't have to check for null pointer exceptions. If you want a null pointer, you have to use it with an optional. ZIG even has a while else statement, so I guess my own programming language is not so special after all. But one of the nicest things about ZIG is how you can run anything at compile time. This is also how ZIG achieves templates. Compile time means the code will run while the code is being compiled, and this also allows, for example, this print method to check if the arguments are correctly passed before running the code. Okay, I have like 20 ZigLinks to go before I finish and find out the surprise at the end, but I wanted to take a break and start working at a simple game. So, I think that Stefan's idea was not that bad after all, and I am bored of making snake clones, so let's make an
Amogus
Flappy Bird copy. I started creating some assets, and by creating, I mean totally stealing them from the web, and then, using this nice framework called Raylib, I started to code the game. Before I tell you my final thoughts, let's go back to the ZigLinks, and it seemed like there was no surprise, or I missed it, I don't know. Let's fix that. Dear ZigLinks creator, there is no surprise after completing the exercises. Please add an
Amogus
game to start when finishing all the ZigLinks. Thanks. Strangely, they deleted my request and didn't respond back. I think I know why. It is definitely because they want to keep it a secret. Anyway, so I have to return to actually working on my Steam game if I ever want to release it. but my overall impression of ZIG is that I might consider moving to it in the future. Many things that I do already in C++ in the ZIG language are features, so even though it will take some time for me to get used to it, it'll probably be worth it. So, if you found this video interesting, don't forget to like and subscribe, post Among Us in the comments section, and if you want to try the game, I'll put a build link on my Discord server. See you!